Welcome, it's Facts You Don't Know. If it's your first time here and you want to find out new facts that will definitely make you smarter and more, well, and first make sure to subscribe and activate the notification bell so you don't miss anything.
Old woman showed a photo of the desired haircut. They laugh at her, but soon they regretted it. It all started on a weekend morning. An older woman named Clara heard that a beauty salon had recently opened in her town. She also knew that they were doing a lot of promotions and offers, so she wanted to go. Thus, upon entering the door, she was very impressed by how welcoming and beautiful everything was. Pictures with girls who had a variety of hairstyles were displayed on the walls. There were large mirrors and shelves with all kinds of beauty products. Looking at the comfortable armchairs, Clara decided to sit down and enjoy a little break while she waited for her turn. After a few minutes, one of the hairdresser's girls got out of bed and approached her. At that moment, Clara told her that she wanted to cut her hair. The women who were present looked at each other and even made their faces of astonishment as the old woman took a seat in the chair that was in front of the mirror for her court. One of the hairdressers who would take care of her said, "And what exactly do you want?" The old woman slowly took out a magazine that she carried in her purse and showed her a cut model that she liked. "Is that the cut you want?" "Yes, young lady. What do you think?" "I think it wouldn't look bad on me." "I can't believe it." She interrupted the hairdresser laughing, showing the magazine page to her other co-workers. They all seemed to mock the old woman's wish. One of them commented, "No, but how can you want that? First of all, it is a youth cut. I mean, for young people. And secondly, her hair is too white and small. With a couple of cuts, you will be left without hair." Another who was in the office added, "That haircut certainly won't fit, ma'am. Do you have any idea how much money this is going to cost you? It's probably all your pension. Better save up. You are very old now. You don't need to do this. Better buy your meds and a cane. You wouldn't mind, huh? Right, girls?" She said these last hurtful words and all of her companions started laughing. A client who was on one side instead of appeasing things added fuel to the fire. "I wouldn't take care of you without you paying me first. I don't care if this old woman has the cut or not. But I have money, ladies. Don't worry about the cost." "What? But how old is that grandmother? You listen. We're still telling you that the cut won't fit you and that it will be very expensive. Don't waste your money, Granny. Your time is up." The old woman then lowered her gaze. It was the first time something like this has happened to her. She felt very sorry and even she shed some tears knowing that no one would help her here. So she left almost humiliated. She walked to the door. She listened. "Yes, you better go. You got the wrong door, old lady," said one of the hairdressers. "This is how Mrs. Clara left the beautiful but not so friendly room." The old woman crossed the park, walked thinking about everything that had happened, and after a few blocks, she didn't have a little hair salon in front of her. She approached through the window. The place was very modest, and there was even only one chair. She also noticed that there were no customers, so she decided to enter. Yes or yes, she wanted the cut so longed for. In the hallway, she was greeted by a young woman. She wore very humble clothes with a simple face. However, appearances could be deceiving. And is that when spending an embarrassing moment, she thought that this other hairdresser could make fun of her by showing her the desired cut. The stylist then imitated the woman to sit in the chair, and suddenly she said, "Ma'am, tell me what haircut you want." "Young lady, I have a magazine with the model. Can I show you?" "Of course I do," replied the young woman. The old woman felt embarrassed again when she searched for the image. Soon, the hairdresser took the magazine, carefully examined the model. She then put it aside and commented, "But what good taste you have, ma'am. She chose the best cut for you." The old woman felt a very different treatment. She was relieved to know that no one else was making fun of her. But suddenly, the hairdresser added, "I just want to tell you something." The old woman changed her face. Was she going to say something bad? She wondered, but suddenly she heard, "I think you should dye your hair, ma'am, so we can give more color and life to your cut. And don't worry, it won't be that expensive. If you like, you can choose a color that is this catalog. Do you think, ma'am?" This is how she gave the stylist several catalogs. "Thank you, daughter. Today I am 62 years old, and I wanted to please myself. A long time ago, I stopped taking care of my appearance. Now I think that my old age should not be an impediment." "Sounds fine to me, and happy birthday, ma'am, but you shouldn't take care of her appearance. It's beautiful in itself." "Thank you, daughter. By the way, what's your name?" asked Mrs. Clara. "My name is Claudia." The young woman smiled and began to work. This is how she began to cut the lady's hair as delicately as if caring for a rose. The old woman even shed a few tears. "Why are you crying, ma'am? Something happened a moment ago? But don't worry, they are things that one has to live." "Okay," said the hairdresser. 2 hours later, Clara saw the result. She was beautiful and well-groomed, and even she, Claudia, gave her a manicure. That lady was really happy. She paid and even tipped the stylist. "Ma'am, it's not necessary. No, daughter, take it as an appreciation. From now on, I will be your client. You have done a great job." "Okay, ma'am. Thank you very much," Claudia said. This is how Clara went out into the street, enjoying a warm summer day. That sadness that she felt hours before definitely changed to happiness. She felt much younger than she really was. She bought a soda, sat in the park, thought about the hairdresser. Such a good person with such a difficult destiny. You see, when Claudia cut her hair, Clara managed to find out more about her sad life. The young woman who had come to the city from the interior of the country was going through a bad time. Turns out that she lives with only her child. While the woman works, the little one's in the nursery. She only has a rented apartment, and even the hair salon's not hers, as she works for someone else, and the salary she receives allows her to adjust and make ends meet. What's more, her son is currently ill and spends everything on him. Sometimes she stops eating for his medicine. Claudia was so worried about all of this. The old woman listened and only replied, "I understand, daughter. It must be difficult. But what about your husband?" "Manuel and I lived for 4 years. We had our son after 2 years of living together. We even lived with my mother-in-law. She always made my life impossible, especially when Manuel went to work in another city." But it was at that moment that Claudia was silent, as if she remembered something that hurt her. Mrs. Clara didn't say a single word either, but then she couldn't keep quiet. "Then what happened?" "Well, Manuel, it wasn't really to work, as he told me. He actually had another wife, and even another child, and he even bought a house for them only. And his mother treated me like a servant every time. Barrett, I left everything and came. I didn't even tell them something because I was afraid they would take my son from me. When I got to this city, I didn't even know how to start." "And your parents?" "I don't have anyone, ma'am. My aunt was the only one who took care of me, but she died when I was 15 years old. They took me to juvenile center, and there they gave me hairdressing classes. When I left, I met Manuel, and he took me to her hometown to live. There, I began to cut people's hair. Little by little, I became known. Not that I earned a fortune, but I was enough to buy food and even medicine for my mother-in-law," said the girl, but she also added, "and when I got to the capital, my son got sick. I took him to the hospital and they told me he had anemia. That's why I work here, ma'am. Luckily, I got this job, although my boss doesn't treat me so well. Sometimes she doesn't pay me. But what can I do? I need the job." That saddened the older woman. She thought, "Why is this world so unfair?" Then the lady walked towards her house. Suddenly, a block before she got there, she heard someone's voice behind her. "Teacher!" Clara turned and looked at a beautiful woman walking towards her and recognized her immediately. She was one of the most diligent and talented former students in her class. Her name, Victoria Fernandez. Clara was delighted with her presence. "But how are you?" "So long, Miss Clara. Remember how the boys were running after you in mass? Likewise, I was just a moment ago. I know you walk fast." This is how both embraced and were happy to see each other again. "I haven't seen you in years. You look very pretty." "Thanks. You are beautiful too, as always." "You finally stayed here," said the old woman, whose turn asked, "How much did you come back from abroad?" "A month ago, teacher. I will be married in a year and a half." "Good, daughter. I'm happy for you," the teacher then commented. "Today's my birthday. If you like, spend a moment with me. We'll sit down and talk. I can even make something to eat. I would like to have company." "Oh, teacher, I would love to, but I can't now. On second thought, my business is very close here. I need to spend a minute to see how things are going. It accompanies me, and from there we eat something. What do you think?" "It is more, I invite. This day will be very special," said the former student. The teacher, who knew that she was not expecting someone, she accepted. She accompanied the young woman. However, the older woman's smile on her face faded when she approached her former student's business, as that establishment turned out to be the room in which she was humiliated. Thus, when they saw Victoria, all the workers stopped laughing and became serious, even very kind to her, but they said they didn't recognize the old lady. At that moment, Mrs. Clara heard, "Teacher, this is my classroom. Now I have my own business, and all thanks to the advice she gave us when we were children, the one of always fighting for our goals." However, the old woman did not want to enter. "Daughter, I better go." "But why, teacher?" Suddenly, the old woman began to cry. What happened? Victoria said. Did I say something wrong? No, daughter, I just can't trust those people. Thank you, dear, for the invitation, but I don't want to ruin my mood again. Wait, I don't understand. What happened, master? This is how the old woman looked at all the employees who offended her, and in front of them, the teacher began to tell what had happened, and upon hearing what happened, they all lowered their heads. The owner was very indignant, and she apologized to her teacher. At that point, she begged her to meet her in her office, that she would give some instructions, then make a couple of calls. When the old woman closed the door, Victoria turned to her employees and very angrily said, "They are all fired. How is it possible that they all offended a client? Moreover, she was my teacher. My classroom is the best in town, and I pay 3 times more than the other salons and still treat clients badly. Is this what I pay them? I don't want to see them again. They are not worthy of this job." The women, who were left speechless, suddenly uttered, "Excuse us, sorry, please, one more chance." However, the woman had already made up her mind. Now the girls no longer had time to laugh and make fun of the person, even more knowing that she was older. This is how Victoria took her teacher to a restaurant, and there had a big surprise for her. The former student managed to invite several more classmates from hers, and the party in the restaurant turned out to be loud and very joyful. Everyone honored the old teacher and congratulated her on her birthday. The next day, Victoria arrived at Claudia's hairdresser, and the two talked. She offered her a job in her classroom thanks to the recommendation of her teacher. The humble woman was very happy, and she accepted all the conditions. In the afternoon, Mrs. Clara approached her and said, "I cannot allow such a good person to deserve this, you know? I have no children or grandchildren. The truth is, I would like you to come with me to my house. This is big, and it wouldn't hurt a little company. I'll see you as a daughter, and I will not charge you anything. You will not need to take care of me. I can still do it myself. There's no better medicine than the happiness of being accompanied by a good person like you. And on the day that I am gone, my home will be yours and your son's." Claudia couldn't believe it. The humble stylist smiled. "I've always dreamed of a daughter like you. Maybe that's why God put you in my way." "Ma'am," the young woman said, crying, "I can never repay you so kindly. Thank you." And they both embraced. Today, Mrs. Clara still visits the place. She is the most spoiled customer. Without a doubt, a wonderful story. I once heard that karma exists. And believe me, it is no coincidence. If you do something good, you'll receive something good. If you do something wrong, you already know what you will receive. Sooner or later, it will pass. I hope you're not surprised. I also hope this video served you well. If so, feel free to give it a thumbs up, to comment, and share.
Thanks for watching. Please like and share the video in social networks. We'll be right back to you as fast as we can.